In my early age, I was very much of a romantic nature. You may call it poetic or something like that. And there was a great saint. He used to come to our house and he was a great poet. Then I told him, I was only 9 or 10 years old. I told him, oh, please teach me poetry also. And then he gave me certain rules. And next day, I went to my garden and there sat and wrote some couplets according to the prosody that he dictated me. And he was very much pleased. Then every day, I used to compose one poem and showed him. Then he declared that you, a great poet is coming. And I was only 11 or 12 years old. My family members thought, my father thought that it is Swamiji, that saint. He composes and gives it to me. But then Swamiji said, no, no, no. You see, the fire was burning. I have just put out the embers from that. He is a great poet. When there was nothing, what was there? Where was a space? Where was time? In what valley of non-existence did I roam then? Where were the unevolved elements? Where was unborn consciousness? In that timeless infinity, when there was neither subject nor object, seer nor seen, when innumerable universes centered in a point were lost in the great void, when the blue sky was not there and the drying of the stars was nowhere to be found. What unknown power had then imagined of this creation? O Father, where were you sleeping in that dark night of forgetfulness? Was I also lying then? Somewhere in your consciousness, like an unknown dream, when without any name or form, you were lost in the void of non-existence. Where was this nature? In what form was my ego? I feel that even then my love was awake. Weeping profusely, it was demanding existence from you. It was that love alone that brought you near my mother. It was that love alone that brought you near my father. It was only due to that light smiled in darkness. Millions of universes burst forth then from the womb of the great void. Countless dormant springs of power were released from every atom. Although every atom was powerless, being subject to its own laws, you, the mover of all, were entirely independent then and are entirely independent now. It is true, eternal Mother Nature is subject to your rules and has to bear the torturous burden of my tears sometimes, but she knows you are always protecting me. Whenever my anguish rising from the depths of my heart reaches you, transgressing all your rules and laws, you always come down to save me. I went to Banaras Hindu. I got my graduation at the age of 14 and went to Banaras Hindu University in intermediate. And there was one symposium, poetic symposium, and there I recited one poem. And the next day I became famous throughout the whole city of Banaras, and everybody talked, and there were magazines, weekly magazines, they printed that a poet, a rose has blossomed in this garden and that, and this and that. And the students also gathered around me. And so that was the beginning. And there was a leader of literary people there, Vedab Banarsi. He was a great humorist poet of India. He was principal of some college also. He took a liking to me and treated me as his son. And as he was invited throughout India for his poems, recitation of his poems, he took me along with him. And there was a All India Hindi Sahitya Sammelan. And he took me, made me a member of that. And there was a Prasad Parishad in which all the great luminaries of Banaras gathered. And the all were university professors and great leaders, some Poonanand, who became the chief minister of UP and all those. So he made me a member of that at the very early age of 17 years. And then I used to recite my poems. And to recite poems in a gathering of such great scholars, it was a great thing. But my mentor, my guru, what you call, he told me that he should be very strict. The poetry should be, if it is read like prose, it should be read, it can be read like prose. You have not to reconcile yourself with grammar. You cannot commit any grammatical mistake. And in such a vast luminaries, I had to be very strict. But they gave me great appreciation. And that was the beginning of my poetry. Because poetry is like a sapling. And if it gets proper water and proper sunrise and all these things, then it prospers. Without any guidance, map or chart, in a vast ocean I have sailed. Bless me if I win your heart, and pardon me if I have failed. To every wind, butterfly and bird, my fragrance freely I give. I have come to make this world a better place to live. The seed he sows and tends each hour takes his whole life to grow. People praise the beauty of the flower who knows the gardener's woes. One another poem I wrote that is very powerful, and I recited in one of the functions there, and then Nirala was the president. He took the mic from my hands, and then for 15 minutes he praised me and said, "You see, those who have got eyes should see there is such a great luminaries in our literature," and so on and so forth. I cannot stop you, O running time, but mark you this my wishful dream, that I on your breast forever shall shine like shadow of moon in a flowing stream. How can you face me when each day you will hear people sing my lyrics sweet? Although my clay will mix with clay, my words will echo by each heartbeat. But if my outward show was poor, I have lived as a prince in poetry's domain. The muses for me have opened their door, and the gods from heaven their blessings did rain. I have fulfilled my life's great dream to create through words universal bond of love and tribute to the power supreme and lively songs all hearts respond. My powers have still their earlier glow, though age will have its share anyway. I hope to be ready when I have to go with no regrets at the close of the day. Some ladies gathered at the end of every month to hear my poems. This translation from this. Then I told them that I like rhymed and rhythm. If I write original poem in English, it will be rhymed and rhythm. They will see the beauty of my words. They were to attend the next day, and I was walking in my garden in Brunswick. There was a rose. I saw it in the morning blooming, and in the evening fading. I said, oh, I am like this rose. I had such a beautiful face. People just looked at me, and you see, I have become crumpled by age. So at once this poem was created. And because the ladies were to gather tomorrow, next day, then I told them, well, today I have written an original poem in English. You hear the melody of my sound. What a waste is life, all tears and strife, the pangs of a broken heart. Love comes and goes as scent of a rose, and the petals fall apart. What love gave once, life robs and runs. The flute falls from my hands, all listeners gone. I roam alone in distant, desolate lands. How far and away is the summer's day when the god of love was young. My time is up, down flows the cup, and the songs lie unsung. Let life fly back on love's lost track. Make me as I was before, or teach my heart the juggler's art that I may grieve no more. So I have given enough poetry today, because it is enough